Hi, everyone. Welcome back to our second annual Daoist Conference, A Post-Pandemic World, Visions of the Dao in a Modern World. Yesterday, we had Josh Painter in the morning teaching us how Taoism views the self and ethical behavior through Taoist scripture, reminding us that the self-help section in the bookstore will always be full. Then we had Dongming Dao helping us to understand the role of daily practice in actualizing these ideas for ourselves, showing us how the I Ching understands good and bad fortune as extremes that will eventually turn into their opposite. Today, we have two great talks for you. We have Master Zhou taking our understanding of the cycles of good fortune and bad fortune even further within the context of the cosmological 60-year cycle and explains practice methods to align our behavior with this Dao. This afternoon, Lindsay Wei will discuss Zhenwu, the patron deity of China's sacred Wudang mountain range, telling us the stories and myths surrounding him that serve as an embodiment of the lifestyle, worldview, and character development of a Wudang Taoist, and also how these spiritual principles connect back to the martial arts associated with this mountain range. So let me introduce Shifu Zhou Xuan Yun. I really don't have any desire here to talk about myself in this conference, but I think my experience meeting Zhou Shifu is a kind of a metaphor for his presence here in America. Not often do we encounter what we were looking to travel across the world for in our own backyard. Several years after I canceled the trip to study Wudang martial arts due to a broken leg, I finally did some research into the martial arts that I was learning here in Boston at the time and realized that we had someone listed as a Wudang monk teaching in Chinatown, two train stops away from my apartment. I wasn't sure what I was getting myself into when I walked into that seventh floor studio that day, but I quickly found out Joshua was the real thing. This was maybe 2015 at the time, and his demonstrations were otherworldly. If you've seen Wudang martial arts, there's this combination of smoothness, flexibility, power, and presence just rolled up into one performance or one application. And it's really, if you've never seen it before, it's something really its own thing. I don't know how else to explain it. And you really feel it when you see it in person, even more so than if you see a video. So it was quite an experience just to like walk into that studio. And that's the first thing I see. I remember talking to a top student of Zhou Shifu at the time, Henry, and I mentioned that I had wanted in the past to travel to Wudang. And he had mentioned, you know, immediately, you know, Wudang is amazing. The power of place is amazing. But you have a teacher here who, you know, his Kung Fu brothers run the schools there. And he's not only did he go through his childhood of becoming a Wudang martial monk, on the mountain, he also studied in the temple afterwards and traveled extensively. And in Henry's terms, it was like Zhou Shifu had added a master's and a doctorate on top of his martial education. So I really didn't understand at the time how much additional training Zhou Shifu really had in ritual divination and meditation in addition to this martial schooling. But over time, I started to figure out just kind of how much he knows when he can just pull out a, you know, long passage of scripture completely out of his memory when he's teaching something. So as amazing as his resume is here, the real teachings that Zhou Shifu offer are his lived experience. I was lucky enough to spend time at the Daoist Center, both as a student on retreat and also helping to build the roof. I've never seen somebody so immune to a setback. He, you know, we figured this out as we went. I didn't realize at the time that, you know, we were just learning how to do this construction. So it was putting everything together step by step, learning it, immediately implementing it. And this man worked like water. He was never stopping, changed direction when it was necessary. And over time, really just wore away at any obstacle that was in his way. And I know that his vision of sharing Taoism in America will be the exact same way. Always moving forward, never stopping, wearing away at whatever obstacles seem to be in his path. And he's going to continue to help spread these teachings in order to help people. So without further ado, Zhou Shifu, why don't you take it away?
Thank you, Sam. Thank you. Amazing. Yesterday, the Mingdao and Josh is very, very amazing. They're very, very good. So, but my English not very well. I have a translator today. I brought someone called Kasi Wu. Here is Wu Bo, his Chinese name, so Wu Bo. He's will help me translate, translating all what I talk, you know. Kasi, can you turn on your... You can't? Okay. I see. Ask to unmute.
Okay, here I am. Thank you.
Thank you. That's Wu Bo. Yeah. 那我们就是昨天这个有点两位已经讲了，就是这个我们讲过了，讲得非常非常好。那我们就是昨天我也提到过，就是因为这个道啊，这个道教啊，或者这个道啊，就是从这个中国到这个西方，还有每个人理解的这个道或者这个道教，它的概念还是不一样的。那就是说我们今天来讲一下，因为这个道教对我们的理解概念，它是分不同的这种怎么说是这个是分不同的这种这种它有不同的这个概念，不同的这种意思。
Okay, yesterday we have two great discussions, and today I'm going to talk about Dao from my own perspective. I know different people have different understandings about Taoism, so today I'm going to present what my understanding of Tao is.
那今天那个道呢，我们先分成一个自然道，然后一个人道和一个道士的一个道，我们把它分三个道给它分开。
Today I'm going to cover three topics. First, I'm going to talk about the natural way, and then I'm going to talk about the Tao of human being, and then the third aspect is the Tao of the Taoist.
那我们先来讲这个道，它在自然中的这种规律和这个就是我们说这个道啊，它是一种自然，它在这个自然关系中，这个道的自然关系它是一种规律，对人来说，对我们来说也是一种行为，但是对，先翻译这么多。
First, in my understanding, the natural way refers to the law of nature and the behavior of human beings. So it reflects the relationship between the nature and the human being.
那我们从这个道的这个自然规律来讲的话，只要有生就有命，就是所有的只要有生，所有的生命，就是所谓的生和命啊，它都有生有灭，就在这个中间呢，它这个生灭之间呢，我们把它称之为有运。
From the perspective of the law of nature, we understand that as long as there is birth, there is fate. Life is the period between birth and death, and there is fate and fortune throughout the whole lifetime. There are good and bad fate or good and bad fortune.
那就是这种运呢、它有好有坏，就是在我们生就是在我们的生命中啊，就遇到的这人不同的这种人呢、或者不同的环境啊，就会改变我们这种不同的这种命运，不同的环境都会改变我们啊，但是都逃脱不了啊，这个人的这个命和运都逃脱不了这个生死这个关系。
Throughout the lifetime of the human being, we encounter different people and different environments, which influence our lifetime. And the common destiny of each life is death.
在中国有句话，我们说有天有不测风云，人有这个旦夕福祸。这个一切事物啊，只要存在运动和这种规律啊，这种运转呢，都属于生命。就是好比这个地球，就是对我们来讲，这个地球它也是有寿命的，那个宇宙啊，它也是有寿命的，对。
There is an old saying in China, the sky is unpredictable, and people's luck and fortune changes overnight. All things in the universe have life, as long as they are in regular movements. The earth has its life, so is the universe. We humans can only tell roughly,rather than specifically the lifespan of the earth and the universe with some calculation skills.
那就是在我们这个人类只要用一种就是推算方法，就我们这个人类就古人的嘛，他用一些简单这种推算方法大致推算出，就是包括我们现在这个人类就是大致的推算出这个地球和这个宇宙的这个生命，就大致都在预测，或者都在这种
What we know about the earth and life is only through detection, through our own thinking, through our own guess. So every ideas might be roughly, not specifically.
那我们现在的这个科学家嘛，就是也一直在就是就预测这种不同的规律，就包括这个天气气候的变化啊，这个火山的爆发啊，每个星球的这种运转的规律啊。
Scientists have been studying on the law of the nature. For instance, the changes of weather and climate, the eruptions of volcano, the movement of each planet.
那从一个道士或者一个修道人的这种概念来讲的话，就是我们来讲的话，天有天运，地有地运，人呢，他也有运，包括地。
Sorry. From the perspective of a Taoist practitioner, the heaven, the earth,and the human being have their own fates.
那我们说就是好比这个这个地震啊，火山的爆发，生物的进化，这都是自然规律。
Earthquakes, volcano eruptions, and biological evolution are all the results of natural laws.
那这种大自然呢，它在不停的这种变化，就是我们所有的这种生物啊，就是小的这种小的细菌，所有的东西它都在不停的这种进化变化。
Nature is constantly changing. Species and bacteria and virus keep evolving.
那就是这样的这种进化，就是好比我们来讲，就好比一个不同的一个肤色的人和一个不同的一个肤色的人结婚生小孩，那小孩呢，他的基因呢，所有东西啊，它都会变化，他的肤色都是有不同的这种变化。
This kind of change is.In the same way as when people of different colors get married and have children, and the children's genes will change.
就是那我们说没有生命啊，只有没有生命，一个死的东西它才会就是停止进化，或者它没有运动才会停止这种进化。
There is life, there is evolution.
那我们现在来讲的话，就是这个好比这个病毒，我们讲这个病毒。那但是什么叫病毒呢？对我来说，它也算是一种细菌。对我们身体有影响的呢，就是对生命有影响的，我们把它称之为病毒。但它没有影响，对我们身体有益的，我会把它称之为细菌啊。
So when we look at the current virus, it is still.Has its own life.
Yeah, 就是如果就好比这个病毒，这个病毒它也在不停的在变异。如果一个东西这个病毒它不懂，那这个就哈，如果作为一种病毒的话，我们很难就是把它给杀死。但是如果就是因为这个病毒它在不同的环境下，它会一直保持着这种变异，就是我们没有办法把它给消灭掉。就好比这个现在这个新冠状病毒一样，它们在不停的变化的时候，我们是没办法。把它给杀死，就在它自然而然变化中，它会变得有一点点弱，或者是我们自己的身体的免疫力会有所提高。我们自己，因为我们身体，我们的人体也是非常非常聪明的，它会有的一种自我保护系统，就在我们身体里面。那所以呢，作为我们的话，我们需要就是给它共存。
Looking at COVID-19 virus, it is easy to kill it when it stops mutating.But as long as it continues its own life and keeps mutating, it's impossible to eliminate it. Therefore, in case of COVID-19, we must learn to coexist with it and to improve our own immunity system.
我们讲一下，就是讲一下这个中国。中国是很有意思的。我们中国呢，就是一种文化，就是我们讲这个运吧，就是中国人呢，用这种纪年的方法。就十二年问一轮，就说哎呀，每一年它有一个相应的一个生肖，就概定这种顺序。所以说我们就是说把这个什么，就像这个鼠年呢、牛年、虎年、兔年、马年呢，就是说猴鸡狗猪，就是不同的这种十二生肖，按它一就是说按它十二年为一个小的一个轮回，这是在地上的称之为地运。
Now we look back to some traditional Chinese philosophy of looking at the universe, and we discuss how do we deal with the current virus and the pandemic situation. So first, I would like to introduce a little bit about Chinese cosmology and the Chinese traditional calendar system. the ancient Chinese people regarded 12 years as one period on Earth, and in each year there is an animal zodiac sign, which is placed in order. And most of you might know, and they are namely rat, ox, tiger, rabbit, dragon, snake, horse, sheep, monkey, rooster, dog, and pig. Also, people know something about the prediction study, believe that the relationship between heaven and earth and human beings undergoes a cycle of rebirth every 60 years.
Yeah, 这个六十家子，我们刚才还漏了一个，我们要讲这个，就是我们还有一个，这是地运，但是我们刚才这个六十家子它是一个人运啊，但是我们还有个天运，天运是十年一个轮回，就是甲乙丙丁啊，无忌更新壬癸，这是天，还有一个天运。对。
Okay, so the circle of 60 years is the fate of the earth.And we have also our own understanding of the fate of the heaven.
它有十年一运，它是十年一个轮回。
And this cycle is 10 years.
Yeah, 那所以说我们这个人运它是六十年，就是说在这个中国，我们从这个历史来讲的话，就是这个每庚子年，就是每六十年呢，它会有一个运，就是每一个每到甲子呢，我们把它大值。庚子啊，每年到这个庚子年的时候，我们大致会把它称之为一个灾年。
So according to history, in this cycle of 60 years, and in every 60 year, so the 60th year, the last year in the cycle is called the year of 庚子 in Chinese era system, which is in no exception the year of disaster in history.
Yeah, 那个我们说比如这个 history, 比如就是以720年的我们说这个鼠疫啊，它带来很多的灾难啊，那就是非常以840年的这种战争啊，还有1900年中国的这个战争，1960年中国这个饥荒啊，它都包括这个200年，如果我们按这个中国这个纪历，这个人运的这种六十年一轮回的这个方推算方法的话，它刚好都是庚子年。
Some evidence of the past, the 60th year, the 庚子 year are, for instance, in the year of 1722, when the plague almost devastated Marseille, killing more than 100,000 people.And then the year of 1840, when the Opium War between China and the United Kingdom broke out. And then the year of 1900, there was the war between China and the Eight Nation Alliance. And also in the same year, the famine of India. And then in the year of 1960, there was the Great Famine in China and followed by 2020,The Great Pandemic.
我们虽然这样讲的话，它是一种简单的推测，但是我们不能否认，只要是就是我们把它给有推测的，它只要是有生命或者是在进行中的事，就是都会有，都要在变化，它都有不确定性。但是这样，它都是一种规律，它都有规律，只要有生命。
Although the previous examples are only very simple examples, and it might be a coincidence, but we have to say the natural way shows that as long as there are life and things in development and evolution, there are changes and uncertainties, which also reflects the natural law of Taoism.
那就是说，如果我们从人类的角度来讲的话，我们想控制这种自然规律这种发展，或者控制这种进化，就是我们站在宇宙这个角度来讲的话，其实我们非常非常渺小。就是我们强行，如果我们自己要强行改变一种规律的话，就是对我们道教来说，对我们那个道士来说，如果强行改变一种规律的话，它可能以后会面临这种更大这种问题。
We have to say it is impossible for human beings to interfere with the natural law or the evolution of certain species. Human beings are only a minor part in the universe and will face serious problems if we push to interfere with the natural development of the nature.
那我们就是昨天我们就是我们先得做一个人类，我们做所有的事物，就做所有的事，考虑所有的问题，我们都是站在我们人的这个角度来去考虑的，我们没有站在一个更高、更大、更广的一个角度来看这个事物的一个问题。这是很自然的，对，就是像我们每个人考虑问题，我们都会站在自己角度来考虑一个问题。如果我们再换一个角度，站在别人的角度。
When we look at the world, when we look at questions and problems, we are always in the perspectives of ourselves, of our human perspective. But if we can stand in another position, it will, we will think in a different way or maybe on a higher level.
OK, 那这个之前呢，我想是在这地方停顿，然后大家来提问。刚才我们把这个整个讲完，我们大家再来聊，再来提问，好吧？
So next we will push to, go on with another second topic, and I will leave question, I will set up some question time at the end of my speech.
OK, 那我们现在就是讲这种人道，就是我们自己的人的这个行为啊，那我人呢？
Sorry, now I come to talk about the way of human being.
那我们人的这个本性的话，我们都是想向往这种美好的生活。我们就说能吃啊，我们希望啊，就是能够吃的吃穿，就是不愁，或者找一个安全的地方，就是繁衍下一代，或者找一个安全的地方，就是我们自己住着。 那么就像这个《道德经》，它就有一句话，我们是说，这个是就是说怎么说，举善地，行善缘，就是这是人的一个很自然的一个人的这种行为。It's
human nature to pursue a better life with no worries about food and clothing, and to find a safe place to raise the next generation. There is an old saying in 道德经, like this: In choosing your home, look to the land. In preparing your heart, go deep. In associating with others, value gentleness.
那就是在中国古代，就是因为如果了解这个儒家的话，都知道中国有个就是大思想家孟子，就孟子的母亲为了孟子的教育，他三次搬家，就是要让这个孟子有一个好的这种环境，然后学习，或者好的环境，来影响他，就是要居住到这种好的环境。
If you know some about the Chinese history, you will know this story. It's a true story. At the later part of the 4th century BC, lived the great thinker Mencius. When he was young, his mother moved three times in order to find a good locality with virtuous neighborhood to influence her son. People always have good expectations towards life and want to live in a good environment. Human beings make all kinds of creations and efforts in order to have a better life.
其实这个就是作为我们现代也是一样。你看，我们每一般一个家就有钱人或者是没钱人，我们都想住到一个好的国家、好的一个地方啊。甚至我们孩子教育，特别有孩子的教育，哎，我们都会找一个学区，什么样的一个学区，有好的这种教育，来用好的这种行为，这个好的这个社区这个环境来影响这个孩子。
So this is the same throughout the world, even nowadays. We want to live in a good country with good education. We want to live in a good community, and we want to provide a very good material life and education for our kids.
那这因为这没办法，这是我们自就是怎么说呢？这就是我们人的这种行为啊，我们所有的努力，包括我们所有的繁衍，所有的这种努力，为了生活，都是。 或者是赚钱呢，干嘛，都是为了有一个就是美好的一个生活，都是向往这种美好的生活。We
work and we make efforts to have a better and better life.
但是另外，我们说是拿的，哎，拿的很，就是另外一个角度来看，就是，但是我们人性它又是多元的，那个人性啊，它是非常复杂的。就是我们人类啊，有了这种物质生活，我们之前讲了，有这种物质生活以后，就做我们自己，那开始让我们都会追求我们这种精神生活。
But human nature are very fine and complicated. After achieving greatly in the material life, people begin to pursue a better and refined spiritual life.
那我们现在就是讲，比如这个艺术，这个宗教、权力，它这个都是一个精神生活。
For instance, in the fields of art, religion, and politics, they are all part of our pursuit of spiritual life.
这没办法。OK, good.
Yes.
其实这个也是就是我们人类和这种动物这种区别。
The pursuit of spiritual life is also the distinction between human beings and animals.
那这个精神生活和物质生活它是相辅相成的，就如果我们能掌握好一种平衡的话，我们说是很好，它是很美满的，但如果掌握不好这种平衡，就是那就会出现问题或者灾难。
Spiritual life and material life are complementary to each other, and it will be very beneficial to achieve harmony between the two. Otherwise, problems and disasters will arise.
那就是我们讲这个人类，如果这个人类的话，他就过度的这个贪欲，这个就是我包括我们的人都是要追求这种完美生活，追求这种精神生活。如果我们要过度的这种贪欲，或者贪婪呢，就是。 那个问题了，因为贪婪呢，贪起我其实对我们人类讲的话，它也是一个弱点。拿一个国家来讲的话，一个国家，它有个领袖，就是这种领袖，或者是这有的国家它是一帮领袖，它不是一个人。那这些人过度的贪婪的话，那就会给这个国家造成一种失去这种平衡，造成一种灾难。如果一个国家的这种总统的话，同时呢对这种权力又非常非常贪婪的话。
In this process of pursuing spiritual life, and if there is greed or greed, and the existence of greed is an obvious weakness of human nature. And if the leader or president of a country is too greedy for power, the country will be out of balance in its development. And disaster will come.
那我们来讲这个，这是就我们就大致讲一下，我们留更多的这个空间，然后大家也来等下来回来，就是来这个聊这个问题。那我们现在讲这个道士的道。Now
we move on to the Tao of the Taoist.
那么讲这个道教呢，我们可以讲它是一种宗教。对我来说的话，它更像是一种科学。 因为这个几千年呢，那道士一直在探索和研究人类和人体，这个人体和这种宇宙的这种关系，都通过这种了解宇宙和人体的关系，就用不同的方法和技术，就让我们自己的生活变得健康，让我们就是快乐的生活，就是说这是道人他们一直追求的这种东西。
Taoism first is a religion, but to me, it is also science. Taoists have been exploring and studying the relationship between the universe and the human body for thousands of years. By understanding the relationship between the universe and the human body, they use different methods and technologies to enable people to live a healthy and happy life.
那我们就是说，我们拿个简单的这个比喻，那就是道士。我们通过这种哲学或者一种心理学，这些方法就是解决人的这种心理问题。那它通过一种我们来讲，就是大家知道，就是内丹或者外丹或者气功，就是解决，包括这个中医，这个医药来解决这个人的身体这种健康问题。
They treat psychological problems of human beings with philosophical, psychological, and other Taoist methods. And they also help to improve the health conditions of people by practicing internal alchemy, external alchemy, traditional Chinese medicine, and qigong, etc.
那我们来讲，肯定这个道教和其实这个道教作为一种宗教的话，它和西方的宗教啊。 它是完全两个概念是不一样的，我们来讲那个宗教，你像这个天主教，它可能在欧洲，整个欧洲最早的话，它是一个权力的一个中心，它虽然信神，但是它更多的是一个权力的中心。但是道教呢，大部分的时间 它是依附着皇权。 怎么说呢？它是一个我们就是像一个道观，它在山上面，它就是通过这种形象呢，就是说跟这个皇帝啊出谋划策，或者说给这个皇帝来讲，哦，这个这一年可能是个什么灾年，这一年是个什么好年，这个好的年成，坏的年成，我们怎么样的防范，好的年成我们怎么去做，这是这个道人呢，就是在古代的时候啊，这个他像是一个机构的啊，他的这种作用啊，对帝王来说。
Taoism as a religion is different from some Western religions such as Christianity. In China, Taoist temples or Taoist institutions, they were subject to the emperor, and they served the emperor by giving suggestions and by making forecasting about the fortune of the country.
那我们在这个地方就是我们要讲到道士的话，我们道士刚才我们讲说有几种方法，我们先讲这个命理学，就是说我们道人呢，他通过你掌握自己的这种命。 或者自己这种运，我们刚说不同，我们研究这个宇宙的自然规律，研究人体的这种规律，然后人体这个所有的这个 destiny 这种命运，然后通过了解和掌握，然后来改变自己。
The first important issue related to Taoism is numerology. This is a study about the fate of human beings and all kinds of species and that of the universe. The fate is the overall view of the life of species and things in the universe, which is composed of each and every happenings throughout a lifetime. So these kind of happenings are called fortune in the overall lifetime of living creature.
对，那我们来讲的话，就是这个道人吧，他最主要的目的，他还是想长寿，或者是不老不死。 这是作为一个修道人，就是我们自己修道人的一个终极一个目标，这很多这个道士把这个就是古代这个修道人，很多人把这个称之为目标，对。
The ultimate goal of practicing Taoism to achieve longevity and even to become immortal. This is the ultimate goal of many Taoists.
那么就是来讲一下这个命，就是这人的这个命啊。这个命啊，就是我们都之前讲过，就是人古人呢对自然界的事物的一种定论，这是这个命，就把一生的这个中各个阶段呢，各个阶段的这种好坏啊，这种运，这种好坏啊，称之为运，就合在一起，我们称为命运。
So, the Taoist perspective of looking at the life of human beings and other living things is looking them as one is fate, and as we have mentioned that fate is the overall view of the life, and under this fate there are several or a series of fortune throughout out of the lifetimes. So the fortune are the happenings, real happenings throughout out of the life. So we look at the lifetime both from fate and fortune.
那我们来讲，就是中国人，如果我们这地方讲到八字，可能对中国这个命理学有了解的人就知道什么生辰八字。这个八字就是中国古人呢，把我们的年月日时用天干和地支，就是排成八个字，作为一个人的这种命运，演算出里面的这种介凶、夫祸，就是不同的这种信息，这就是我们讲这是人的命。
Taoist priests believe that by getting to know their own destiny and then changing it with some practice and methods, they can become immortals. For example, in case of a serious disaster is forecasted in a particular month of a particular year, people will first analyze. There is a little bit misunderstanding, okay? So first they will study the fate. How do they study the fate of a human life? So they will have four Chinese characters to describe the real human life. So these four characters, um, uh, six, eight characters are coming from the year, the month, the date, and the time of the birth. So for each quota, like the year, it's related to two characters, and the month is related to another two. The date is denoted by other two characters, and the time is also denoted by two characters. So there are eight characters altogether, which can describe the overall fate of a human being.
就是我们讲，因为这个每个人他的五行的不同啊，就是这个人的这个运呐，他都也不同了，和就是说，因为这个人的这个五行就是在这个排列的过程中，他的五行不同啊，然后不行，他的命不一样，就是这样合起来就每个人的命，这就一个人的命运，但是他的命运呢，同时也是不同的啊，这我们说这个东西啊，这就是上天注定的。 任命的人呢，就会，很多人都会说啊，这就是我们这个命运，我们这个每个人不同的这个命运，我们就应该顺其自然啊，应该顺着这个老天，因为他是主宰嘛，我们就要顺着他们来，对。And
also there are five elements of the human life or of the life of every living creature. And you may know these five elements, basic elements in Taoist philosophy are gold, wood, water, fire, and the earth. So these five elements is particular. Each person's five elements are different from the other. So these five elements together with the eight characters can tell specifically about their fate and the fortune of a specific person.
那么道士就是 我们之前讲，就像我们这个，我不能说这个道士，在古代很多包括他不是道士的人，有很多人在修行啊，就通过就是了解这种自己的这种命啊，很多人都相信这个，通过了解自己的这种命运啊，然后再通过一些这种方法，还得技术来改变它啊，然后可以就是哎长生不老或者成仙啊。So
by getting to know the eight characters, which is specific to each person, and by analyzing the five elements conditions of a particular person, Taoist priest, they know the fate and the fortune of that person.
那我们怎么来掌握呢？就是我们来打一个比喻，就是我们推算出，通过这种形式推算出哪一年哪一月它会有这个灾难，会有个什么样的灾难。 通过了解这种灾难的这种属性，就是我们说是金木水火土，然后就是进行这种防范，或者待在家里面，这个月对我来说不好，我不能出门，我就待在家里面，就是或者做事就是要非常非常小心。
So by analyzing the eight characters and by knowing the five elements of that particular person, they will tell the coming fortune of that person. Okay, if they forecast a particular disaster will happen in a particular month of a particular year, then the Taoist monk will try to first analyze the attributes of that disaster. What kind of a nature that disaster has, for instance, is it related to gold, wood, water, fire, or soil? And then if they decide what's the attribute of the disaster, they will try to avoid the disaster accordingly. For instance, they would choose to stay at home and avoid doing stay at home or do everything with extreme carefulness.
其实这种文化呢，这种就是我们说这种，就包括这种算命这种文化吧，就是在中国古代流行，其实在现在也很流行。那就是在特别是在古代，我们不管是你是富有的还是有权利的、有穷人的，包括我们是婚姻啊，或者是这个或者是有什么这个办一个什么活动或者做什么，它都是要选日子的。 包括这婚，特别是婚姻，那我们两个人的这个生辰八字还放在一起， 那他不好的话呢, 那他们这个婚姻基本上不行了。那就是在中国古代这个婚姻最早就是叫对八字啊。第一个我们这个地方是dating，我们说是哎见面聊一聊。在中国不对啊，我们知道是看中了，两个差不多的话，第五步就是先把两个人的八字放到一起，然后看一看。The
practice of fortune telling or disaster forecasting was very popular in ancient China. As a matter of fact, it is still very popular nowadays. For instance, whether they are people are celebrities or ordinary or poor people, usually it's quite common practice to find a fortune teller to tell whether the eight characters of two unmarried couple match each other before the wedding. It's very common even nowadays, and they will try to figure out when is the best day, best time to get married.
那我们包括这个，我们这是这个，对，我们现在你看，其实在中国的话，我们了解的话，就是我们自己了解，自己尤其是书啊，或者这个道教里面的这个人呢，经常给会给一些特别有权利的人，或者特别有钱的人，经常给他们看风水呀，我们说就是算命啊，这是很常见的，经常到他们家给他们算命啊。所以说在中国就是说，我们来讲就是。 这是我自己来讲出来，就是说特别富有的人，他们后面呢都会由这一些，就是给他看命的人，经常给他们做预测的人，就是在跟着他们，就是经常他们会找这个人来算个卦，或者是通过一种形式算卦或者算命来给他们怎么说，就是说来看他们的这个运势的一个好坏。对。
Even today, it is very common to avoid evil fate and evil fortune throughout forecasting. It's a matter of fact nowadays in China, the financial tycoons or the very rich people, they always secretly or publicly seek some Taoist fortune tellers or somebody who knows Taoism to help them by predicting the forthcoming event or try to maintain, secure the good luck and to avoid the evil. So things and positions means they are the position that you are in, or the position of the houses, or the position or the location of the human being that will bring bad luck will become taboos. They will try to avoid to be in that kind of position, or they will try to avoid doing that things. And the timing of gaining fortune and unfavorable conditions and the timing of losing fortune or unfavorable orientations are taboos, and the timing of making a fortune and getting promoted should never be missed.
这是这个命运，但是我们说呢，出家呢住在道观里面或者住在这个庙观里面，它也算是一种修行方法。 那所以说就是住在道观，对道人来说，就是我们说，哎，这就是一种修行方法，那这也是一种就是改变命运的这种方法，啊。And
to live in a Taoist temple is also a way of practicing Taoism and changing fate. To live in a Taoist temple.
就是在中国，最后在古代，包括在现在也是很常见。就是在这个，那小孩子啊，就是出生以后，我们说太多灾难啊。那个或者有的，我们说灾难，有的时候是经常生病，或者是就是到医院里面看不好啊，就是没办法了。那时候父母啊就会想着把这个小孩呀送到道观里面拜一个师傅，就是住在里面啊，通过这种方法来改变这个小孩子的这种命运，或者说是躲灾。对。For
instance, if a child was born sick, parents would send him to a Taoist temple to be taught by a Taoist priest in the hope of avoiding the ill luck and changing his
fate. 那我们来说，住在道观里面怎么成改变成命运呢？我们想住在道观里面呢，他的每天的生活啊，就是一样的，他清茶淡饭呢，念经啊，和打理道观呢，他的生活从这个五行上面，他不受这种五行的这种控制。 啊，如果生活都一样的话，他都没有灾，没有难了，所有的生活都是一样的，他的命运也是一样的。
Why to live in a Taoist temple could be a way of avoiding avoiding ill fate. Because basically, life in a Taoist temple is the same every day. They eat simple food, they chant scriptures, and taking care of the temple. The five elements of that person would not be disturbed in that monotonous and quiet life. So the evil fate would be avoided.
但是我们在讲另一个从另一面来讲，他住在道观里面呢，他也并不是一件容易的事，他就需要这个我们说是个定力和毅力啊，就是说真的我们要作为一个成年，作为一个修道人呢，我们要舍弃这种七情和六欲啊，就是好比这种喜怒哀乐啊，就这种东西啊，就是说不受我们自己的这种感情或者emotion这种支配啊，就是不然的话，
As we know, living in the Taoist temple and to live a same life every day, so the five elements would not be influenced, and fate, the potential ill fate will naturally be avoided. However, to live in a Taoist temple demands for great perseverance and concentration. Without being subjected to your feelings, emotions, and desires. Otherwise, if your feelings are in great fluctuation, then many problems or serious problems will occur.
那我自己在云游的时候啊, 我就是自己在到处采访访道学习的时候去走到道观，我们包括上的华山武当山呢，它都有在这种案例，都是有这种例子，听到哎呀，谁这一段时间有问题，然后他跳崖，他说他自己要成仙了啊，他马上成仙了，他就从悬崖上面跳下去了，他觉得哦，这就我现在就成仙了，这就是这种他在这个道观里面改变命运过程中啊，就是说他对这个心不定啊，或者这个意不坚所产生的出现一种我们这
When I was in my when I was young and was wandering as a Taoist priest and visiting some other Taoist temples, for instance in Wudang Mountain or in Huashan Mountain, I heard about other Taoist monks jumping off the cliff because they believed that they had become immortals. So that means they are suffering from the mental disorder because they could not concentrate in the simple Taoist life.
因为现在的话，我们这个道观和这个佛教它是还好一些，就是说，特别因为现在的话，很多的这个道观它有点像上班的形式，道人的修道的同时像上班，包括佛教的地方，他们 都允许这个婚姻。其实在我在当时去就是云游的时候，而且在道观里面就是这种同性恋，其实在道观里面和佛教里面，它这个佛这个什么这个佛教的寺庙，它特别特别常见和特别特别多。对，这也是一个问题。
Because of that specific lifestyle in Taoist temples
and Buddha,
so. And also the same in Buddhist temples, mental disorder of Taoists and monks, and also it was very common. And also homosexuals are also common in Taoist temples. Nowadays, situations are changing a little bit because to practice Taoism in Taoist temples is like a career. So Taoists, now they are allowed to get married and having their own family. So they are living a life which is closer to common people.
那我们现在这个社会啊，就是我们就是从过这个来讲的话，我们现在这个社会啊，就是为什么这个精神问题啊，就是很多它是举高不下，很多很多。那这就是我们现在这种生活，它这个不健康，就是对比我们现在社会啊，和这个道教的这种古代这个住在道观的这种生活啊，那就是和我们现在的健康生活，它都是有关的。我们现在人就是出现这种问题，就是人们呢都是太缺少社交了，缺少这种信任。
Mental problems are common in modern society due to unhealthy lifestyle, lack of social contact, and lack of trust among people. So this kind of lack of social contact is common with that kind of isolation in Taoist temple. So a huge number of people suffer from mental and psychological problems.
那么像就是当时在这个pandemic这个期间，那我当时就是他们一说要封城的时候，我说完了，所以呢，从他们就是我从一个数据上来看，就是在这个pandemic它的一个封闭期间，人的这个精神状况出现问题的，它增长了20%。所以说我当，因为我很早都知道这个，因为我是住在道观里，我说，哎，这个完了，很多精神出现问题了。
So the situation is the same in the lockdown of the pandemic. And back to that earlier 3 years when I heard that some places started to lock down or government to lock down the city. So I felt it would be a great disaster because I totally feel from my own experience and from my own understanding of the Taoist temple life, I know it would be great possibility for people to suffer from mental problems during that kind of lockdown. And later the data shows that the mental problem arises to by 20% compared with the time before the pandemic lockdown.
那我们就是说，我们再讲一下这个风水学。其实我们在改变命运的，改变很多东西，还有一个风水，在道教里面，很多人都知道这个风水。那我们说说。Now
we move on to feng shui, because feng shui is also another element or issue that is related to the change of fate.
那我来讲的话，对我来讲的话，风水学它更是一个科学，它更是一种自然科学，对我来说啊。 就是它是一个心理学和这种科学的一种结合体，自然科学和心理的那我们来讲，很多人就是相信呢，这个地球啊，它在运动啊，那就是好比这个月缺月圆呢，和这种潮水啊，就是说大起大落啊，它都和着我们这个身体啊有关系。那这个风水这个关系呢，它就是说是一样的。你先翻译这么多。
Feng Shui, in my opinion, is a combination of natural science and psychology. Many people believe that the rotation of the earth and the waxing and waning of the moon and the ebb and flow of the ocean affects the magnetic field of the earth and the circulation of qi.
那么说风水啊，这个关系呢，就是好比这个风水可以影响到 我们的这个磁场和气的这种流通，就是一个你住在一个好的地方，就是你这个风水的一个好坏，它可以影响到这个磁场的这种运动和这个气的这种流通。那进一步呢，它也会影响到我们身体的健康和心情。And
this changing of magnetic field and the circulation of qi will further influence the psychological and physical conditions of human being.
那我们都知道，人的这个心情的好坏，可以影响到我们自己的这个家庭的和谐不和谐，或者事业的成功与不成功。因为这个都是取决于我们自己的，很多的时候是取决于我们自己的这种心情和这种逻辑。那就好比我们经常出现这种这个心情不好啊，然后太 emotion， 那我们都会失去这种逻辑或者是清晰的去考虑一些问题。
The mood of a person decides whether the family is happy and the career is successful. It is difficult to think clearly and logically when people are in a bad mood.
那所以我们从这个地方来讲的话，就是好的风水呀，可以其实对我们来个道理讲，那好的风水呀，它还可以起到一个治疗疾病的一种作用。 因为这能影响你的心情，那么影响了心情呢，对我们身体是很多的疾病，它是起到这种关键的作用。So
a good feng shui will put people in good mood, and then help people to maintain good health conditions. And also, it will be helpful in the treatment of certain disease.
那我们肯定，我们就打个简单的一个比喻啊，一个人的你的家庭里面就是乱得很，那外面乱得很，这个风水非常不好，这是个简单的一个比喻。那你一回去心情都特别不爽，那你心情不爽的话，你和你家人啊聊天呐，孩子聊天，你这个心情把所有的这种不好的东西都给带来。那我们说是在这个公司里面，本来或者在这个地方，那个心情都非常不好，有很多几个一回去又看到这些。 不好的这种环境或者这种风水啊，我们讲的叫风水啊，就是到处很乱，或者到处就是哪个地方看着也不顺眼，那这时候影响到我们心情都会，可能有的人都会崩溃啊，有的人都很难受。那么说是，可能我们心情非常不好，从一个地方回来，但是我们回到家以后，哎呀，你感觉哎呀这个家很舒服啊，到处看到都很顺心，那一下子把你的身体给疏通了。
We all have the experience of being in a bad conditions or in a bad setting, in a disorder setting, which means it's in a bad feng shui. Then we will naturally feel down, and the family won't live in a happy mood and won't live in a harmonic daily life, and on the contrary, so if you are in a good feng shui environment and in a very order and surroundings, so you will have a very clear mind and you will in a happy mood. So everything will be getting along with each other very smoothly.
那我们来讲这个法术，那时候在这个道教呢非常常见，特别是一个正义派啊，或者另外一个道教，另外一个派系，他们讲到这个法术都是非常非常常见的。那很多人呢，哎呀，一想到这个联想的，就在中国很多人，哎，道士，想到这个道士呢，道士啊，可能都会画符念咒啊，什么法术都会想到这个这些技术这些东西。
Following feng shui, another concept related to Taoism is magic. Taoist magic or Taoist magic arts. So what is Taoist magic? This question naturally associates people with chanting spells.
那我们对我们来说这个法，如果我自己把它给分开理解的话，就是法什么就是自然界的这种规则，术，或者是一种技术，一种手段。
就是我们就是这个道士，那个法术啊，也就是说道士用来解决啊在生活一些心理问题啊，那就是也有人就是这个道士，我们可以说是用这个法术来治病啊，或者是驱鬼驱邪呀，那我在古代的话，这个也有这个人，哎呦，用这个法术其实就是一种心理战术的话，这样的话就是说怎么说去打仗啊。In my understanding,
Taoist magic is to use Taoist methods and practices on the basis of the law of nature. Taoist magics are used to solve psychological problems of human beings and to treat disease, to exorcise ghosts and evil spirits, and to fight wars.
那我们再讲这个法术，这个治病。
Taoist magic is always based, the practice of Taoist magic is always based on the understanding of the mentality and psychological activities of the human being.
那么讲的就讲一个就是用这个法术治病的故事。我当时在云游的时候，在一个道观里面，就是当时有一个女的，她是一个降，我们称之为降客，像个游客一样，就是谁到这个这里面去看他们，然后到那个里面呢，就是见到这个怎么道长说，哎呀，就是他就是很浑身没力气，就说，哎呀，道长，我的身体非常不舒服，每天没力气，怎么办呢？我怎么哎那个道长说啊，那我现在用这个法术来给你治病吧。 他用这个手在他的身体里面弄弄啊，你要 peace peace，然后怎么样啊？就给他讲一下啊，你安静安静。然后使劲大叫了一声，然后啊，然后那个女的呢一下精神给起来了，她马上精神，她都有力了，她一下就能看到精神去了。她说：“哎呀，是道长，道长，我治好了，我治好了。”然后一下子把他这个精神给振奋起来了啊，就是说他从这个上面，就是我们说用气治病或者用法术治病啊，它是一种心理的，很多的时候是心理的一个活动问题。
I witnessed how a Taoist priest treated a sick visitor in the Taoist temple by myself. That was when I was visiting a Taoist temple. A female visitor came to this Taoist temple and told a priest of that temple by complaining she was feeling very weak and depressed and in very low mood. So the priest was using hand gestures like weaving and his hands time and again in front of the female visitor for quite some time, and followed by a very loud shout. And suddenly the female visitor was kind of shocked and immediately became very spirited. And she said, okay, now I feel so energetic and feel I'm in a very good mood. So according to my observation, this is a kind of a psychological treatment.
那我们汉语讲故事，那道教这个法术它不光这一方面，或者用气功治病，那还有一个方面，他们就是说会用这个纸，就是我们在上面画一个东西，然后烧水喝了。但是道人一般用那个纸张啊，或者他们用的那个东西，就是画符的东西，它都有一些中药的一些成分啊。 它很多的中药成分，所以他们会说，哦，那我们先给你画一个符，然后喝了。那这个中药的成分和这个人的心理问题啊，这个心理作用啊，它是相结合，然后通过这种形式来治病。Okay,
so the Taoist priest not only treat disease with the psychological measures, but also you may know there is another way of treat disease is that they will draw some certain signs on certain piece of paper, and then they burn this paper into ashes and put them into the water, and they ask the sick person to drink the water, and then the disease was treated properly. The patient become healthy again. So actually for this particular paper and the color that are used to draw the sign, Taoist sign, they contain some herbal medical ingredients.
那我们对，这是这个治病，就我这个故事我们讲的。那我们就是说，那我有善，就是说这个心理作用呢，只是在每个地方都能用到。那我们经常也给别人说，哎，讲这个开玩笑。我们说朋友开玩笑，我们说现在这个人呢，那个法术更厉害，就包括在这个商业方面啊，这个包括在这个政治方面，他都会去到处去调查呀，就是说怎么说这个人类的这种心理活动。 然后呢，就是通过我卖什么样的一个产品，或者是通过这种虚假新闻呐，或者这种手段呐，还不同的形式来达到，就是说自己想要的这种怎么说，想要的一种效果，或者通过这种方法呢，就是战胜自己的对手或一个国家，就是这是现代的一个人，就是非这是现代社会非常常用的，这个生意啊和一个政治家非常常用的一些手段。
In modern contemporary society, people also use Taoist magic in the business and the political fields. For instance, on the basis of a psychological analysis, people sell just the concepts rather than real products at very high prices. In politics, people produce fake news, smear opponents in order to defeat an opponent or a country. So there are Taoist mentality and psychology behind all these measures.
那因为这是我们自己是一个怎么说一个 joke， 就是一个开玩笑的这种形式说，现在的人去用道士这个 magic， 其实它还是一个心理的一个，就是运用人的这种心理的这种怎么说心理活动这种行为去做的一种事情，对。
So Taoist magic in essence is a psychological analysis.
嗯，那我们就是我们讲，哎呀，我们古代的道人和现代的不一样。我们说，哎，古代道人用这个人是治疗人的这种心理问题啊，解决啊这个人类的一些疾病或者一些问题。那现代人呢，就是用这种行为呢，是满足自己的这种欲望，所以它的两个概念不一样。
But according to my observation, in the ancient or traditional Taoist practice, and Taoists, they practice Taoist magic to help people, both psychologically and physically, or to, but nowadays, Taoist magic is used as a weapon to satisfy personal desires.
那我们来讲，就是在这个道人这个修行过程中，他有一个就是辟谷，这是在西方很多人都知道的。那古人呢，就是我们说修行的道士呢。
Following this Taoist magic, we move on to another topic is Taoist diet. And you know, many of you might know, this is also called 辟谷 in Chinese diet, Taoist diet.
嗯，那我们说，我就是古代，我们这样说，这古代的修行者或者一些道士啊，就是说怎么说呢，认为就是人呢吃这种五谷啊杂粮啊都会生病，因为这个五谷呢，我们就是认为这五谷在我们身体这个肠胃里面呢都会产生这种浊气，就是说你产生这种浊气的话你都不能成仙了啊。所以他们在闭关修行的时候就是说，哎，那我们就说不要吃这种五谷杂粮啊，那我们就是吃一些这种草药啊，通过这种练习气功啊，或者这种打坐练内丹呢 啊能够就是让身体不生病，或者达到一种这种不死的这种效果啊。
Ancient Taoist practitioners and Taoist priests believed that people who eat normal food will become ill because food produces waste inside our body and thus prevent Taoists to become immortals and to attain the Tao. Therefore, they only ate some nutritious herbs in the period of retreat. Besides, they also practiced Qigong and meditation to prevent illness, keep young, and to become immortals.
那我们这个道人的辟谷和是西方这个不太一样，我们这个西方很多人讲，哎，这是断粮，就是一段时间什么都不吃啊。就是在古代我们也有这种断粮，但是断粮啊，就是在只有在这种治疗疾病的过程中啊，或者在这个吃这个中药的时候，就是你断粮的话啊，就是你不吃饭的时候才能让身体更好的吸收这种药的这成分啊。
Taoist diet is not fasting in the Western ideas.Nor it is the forbidden of food as it was practiced in the traditional medicine. Because in traditional medicine, by giving up food, the patient's body will take in healing ingredients of the herb medicine to the maximum extent.
那我们就是作为现在的话，我们说现在这个营养太过剩了，特别在这个发达国家人都吃的太多了，那所以说就我们适当的断粮呢，其实它对人身体健康是有好处的，而且呢就是说怎么说呢，而且还能提高我们的免疫力，就是在这个现在。
In today, the body of human beings tend to store surplus food and nutrition, which turn out to be a burden to the body. Thus, to practice Taoist dietproperly will improve the immunity system of the body.
那我们就是说对，这我们就是讲这个内丹，我们再就是道教另外一种这种修行方法，我们讲这个内丹，就是说在这个古代呢，先翻译这么多吧。
The next practicing method, Taoist practice method is to practice internal alchemy.
那我们是在古代这个中医啊，就是炼制这种药丸呢，就是这个怎么说那个药丸呢，就是说它是很神秘的。
师傅，你是说内丹还是外丹？
内丹，内丹。我们现在在这个像我们先讲在这个内丹呢 就是另一种药丸呢，药丸就是在古代它很神秘嘛，所以我们就是说在这个小说里面呢，经常人看到吃这种药丸呢，丹丸呢，药啊，或者说就是能够得到成仙啊，我们现在先讲这么多，对。
In ancient times, the kind of medical pills are regarded very mysterious. There were a lot of legends and mysteries about the traditional medical pills in stories and movies.
那所以说呢，就是说我们这个，我们在练这个内丹的时候，就是说，这个丹呢，其实就是说在古代称之为药丸，那到我们身体里面呢，它也称之为内丹。
Some people believe that by taking the pills, the dead will retrieve back their lives and the people will live in an eternal life. But there is another kind of pill, which is not in the form of a medical pill, but it's kind of to using the inner energy of your body.
那所以说我们就是那个人呢都希望通过这种方法，就是我们说道教就是主张，那我们说是练这个，用这个精气神，就是练这种内丹，哎呀，他你身体成内丹以后，那就是我们外用呢，它也是称之为一种这种累发，或者一种这种方法，可以引雷啊，可以让这个雷啊掌握在你的手里面，它这是一种想法，一种，它这是一种境界，或者一种想法。
So to practice this kind of an internal alchemy, you need to follow the change of yin and yang and to integrate the body with the nature. The body is the container and the spirit and the qi are the materials. The person practices the circulation of respiration inside the whole body to generate new energy and to store it in the body for future use. Then this kind of energy is believed powerful in treating all kinds of diseases.
那行吧，这是个内丹，就是我们在讲一下这个气功啊，就是我们这个气功呢，我们都知道，就是不管是你练习什么气功啊，我们都需要心境，就是不管你练内丹呢，练气功啊，还做什么，包括我们做什么，都是这个心境是非常非常重要的啊，就是在这个气功里面，我们现在讲这个气功吧。
In addition to internal alchemy, another practice method is qigong, which most of you are familiar with.
那么就是说，这个生命啊，就是最好的营养。那对于这个道教啊，或者对我们这个修行啊和练气功的人来讲的话，生命就最好的营养，它就是这个心境啊。人们都知道，就是我们这个身体啊，从这个食物中获取营养和能量。 但是从这个安静中获取我们所需要就是更强的这种能量。The
best nutrition of life comes from a peaceful mind. We all know that our body gets energy from food, but the most powerful energy comes from peace.
然后说，在高压社会，我们现在特别来讲的话，在现在的这个高压社会，就是这个压力非常大呀，就是怎么说，安静呢，也能成为我们这种灵魂啊，灵魂这种归宿，就是就是这个安静呢，同时呀，也能治好啊很多这种，就是我们自己心里这种疾病，所以这个安静呢是非常非常重要的。In
the modern society with pressure and intense competition, peacefulness is the final destination of our souls. And it is also the best medicine for many diseases.
那我们就是说，为什么我们就是说现在需要睡觉呢？就是我们好比我们身体里啊是一台机器，每天呢我们都是在高速的这种运转呢，都在工作呀，就是休息它非常非常重要。就是所以说，就是我们恢复这个身体的这种能量，就是我们需要这个睡觉。 休息。对。
Why do we need sleep and rest? Because our body is a machine that works at high speed every day. Only by sleeping and resting can we restore the energy in our body.
所以我们就像讲，我们有的时候给学生也会这样去讲，就是休息啊，也可以说是这种休息也是治病最好的药，也是这种健康的一个根本啊。所以说，在我们累啊、烦躁的时候啊，哎，清静啊，然后这个休息是非常非常重要的。
I often tell my students that rest is a good medicine and the foundation of health. When we are tired and irritated, keeping calm and peaceful is the best solution.
Yeah, 你看，我们说是这个，我们是这个，你一个这个心境啊，也是打开这种忧郁的一个阀门。我们怎么讲呢？就是像我们在我们这个生活这个压力很大呀、啊。那么经常就疲惫不堪的患得患失啊，就是心浮气躁啊，就谁都不会喜欢你啊。然后你到一个地方和人交流的话，别人看到你这个人这么烦躁，他也不想跟你就是交流，作为一种朋友。所以就是我们如果要能保持这个心境的话，就是说哎，也能给别人带来欢心啊，就是你自己啊也会有这种包容心呢、啊。所以说这个我们这个心境啊，它也是一种就是说这时候我们说是从另外一个角度来讲的话，就是宇宙的能量啊。就也能进入到我们身体里面，然后去和朋友啊、家人啊交往啊，和你的这种朋友交往啊，都能带来非常好的这种信任和快乐和安静。所以呢，心境呢，它也是一个优异的一个阀门。
Also, to have a peaceful heart is the door to friendship. The pressure of life makes us tired, worrying, and restless, which are also bothering to other people.When your heart is peaceful, joyful, and open, the energy of the universe will flow into your body steadily and continuously, and will make it easier to communicate with friends and to gain their trust. You will make other people feel happy and quiet, as well as with a peaceful heart.
那么来说，清静也可以打，我们说是一个接受能量的一个阀门。我们之前讲，那就是如果我们走在清静的时候，我们才能接受你自然中的这种力量，就是说只有把自己的这个脑袋里面很多时候放空，把所有东西放开啊，才能接受这种新的这种事物。一个人的成功啊和能量的大小啊，这种智慧它都是有关系的啊。我们说哎，一个人就是说这种号召能力非常强的原因，就是他们内心呢蕴藏着这种就是他们非常有智慧，而且他们的信念呢非常有信念啊，因为他们就是能调动来能量，就是这种灵能量啊，能来帮助他做事情。就是我们说这种能量呢，它是来源于天地，也是来源于自己的这种心境，和心境这种关系都有很大的这种关系。对。
And also being peaceful is the way to receive energy from the universe. Only when you are in peace can you receive energy from the universe.With peaceful mind and heart, you can remove the old and waste from the body and receive the new energy from the nature. A person's success is related to ability and wisdom. However, the most important key to success is the person's ability to appeal to the nature and the universe. Whenever they want to, they are able to receive energy from heaven and earth to help them.To fulfill their dreams.
那我们说是这个清静的话，它也会能打开我们的智慧。就是我们在处理一些复杂的事情啊，或者说百思不得其解，或者就是说很难很难，我们很思虑的时候，哎，我们只要能清静一下的话，我们有的时候我们叫灵光一闪，有的时候哎一下都起来了，一下都找到一个解决的问题了啊，那这问题就解决了。就是所以说清静，它也是一种能量，也是一种打开智慧的阀门啊。那所以说我们说这个清静非常非常重要。
Only when people are in peaceful status can they accept energy from the nature. How much energy people will finally get from the nature depends on to what extent they are able to keep their heart and mind open and peaceful. Being peaceful will hopefully make people enlightened.In a complicated situation and find an unexpected solution. When people calm down and become peaceful, wisdom will be called.
那所以说不管我们是练内丹打坐在生活中啊，它所有的东西就是清静非常非常重要啊。嗯，这个嗯，那我们是在打坐的时候，你要是不清静的话，你是没办法打坐，你练内丹，你就是没有静下心来，你没办法练内丹，它的气在你身体里面都起不来啊。所以在我们生活中，如果你不会清静的话， 就是我们生活都非常非常乱，所以说清静是非常非常重要，是所有我们人类就是解决一切事物的一个法门，就清静非常重要。Actually,
being peaceful is the key point in practicing Taoist practices, like and practicing an internal alchemy and practice meditation. If you are not in a peaceful mood, it's impossible for you to do any kinds of ties the practices.
嗯，反正对，我们就是，我们也讲句，我OK。师傅，
just mentioning that we're a little bit over time.
Oh, okay.
So I want to just mention that just because I know some people probably want to ask questions. Letting you know that you decide what you want to do.
Okay, thank you. So we don't know. Actually, we don't know. I just want to say something. So, 那我们现在就是完了。那我们就是我们讲这么多呢，我们讲和没讲它是一样的。如果你要是从我们这个上面讲的这个上面得到一些启发，如果能学到一些东西，那就是说明我讲了。如果学不到什么东西，那和没讲是一样的。就是所有的这种事物，就是说我们这种讲课说的东西，就是说怎么说 depend，就是说是每个人的这种情况不一样，习俗的东西不一样，这 depend 的啊。
So now it comes to the question time.
Okay.
So we'll keep doing the questions like we have been doing for this conference. So if people have questions and want to put them in the chat, I'll read them out loud just so we have a little organization behind the questions. We've covered a bunch of topics today, so, you know, I have some questions if people don't have some in a couple minutes, for sure.
So, I hope I can give some people inspiration. You know, I'm also a philosopher. I always tell the people what I say. You know, is the what I didn't say. If you got it, I say something. If you didn't got it, means I say that I know anything. Because as a Chinese, we call the wu, wubo, what's it called? The jiu. The everything is 我给你, 就是我给别人讲了, 然后让别人来想。
师父,你想让我翻译这个吗?
对。
OK,你能再简单的说一遍吗?
就是说我讲的这个问题, 如果我要是把这个事情给讲了, 就我希望给大家一些灵感, 就是让大家能找到一些灵感。 就是说, 中国的这个文化讲的是一个物字, 就是如果看每个人领悟的多少。
Okay. So I hope just now I have covered some basic practice Taoist methods, and I hope which will enlighten you to some extent, and now you can present your own reflections and questions.
All right, so we have a first question from Robert, who says, thank you very much, Master Zhou. The talk was enlightening. Can you please tell us how non-Chinese people can learn the core concepts of Taoist religion? There are many conflicting ideas in the community, and it's not always clear where to start.
Okay. One minute. So I'm not really understand the question, but just a little bit, waiting a little bit, I see.
Yeah, so he's, unless you want it translated, he's asking the most fundamental, most basic parts of
yeah.
Taoism, what is most important and where to start when practicing Taoism in the West.
Actually, not just like in China and in West, it's like really like difficult for people to hard to find the gate. We say hard to find the gate, where you start to learn. So either in China, it's a lot of priests, like people want to learn Taoism. It's difficult, you know, because they want to learn, someone want to learn a skill, someone want to like Taoism. So for me, in the West, because in the temple and the past also is different. So for me, I know you can just reading some book, you know, have a lot of good book. So we, you know, you can start to learn. Of course, the book most time is from the scholarship's angle to see what's the Daoism. If you can find a teacher, the best is you can find a teacher that can tell you what you study, where you want to learn. But in the West, the same. We most who are interesting about Daoist for now, okay. In the past, the hippie, because they want to find the life of what, the hippie. I not say they smoke marijuana, okay. They just, oh, there's a Dao, I want to everything follow the natural. The past, you know, it's like 60, 70 years ago, that's a hippie. They want to learn the Daoism. But not a lot of people want to learn the Daoism. It's like the skills. So we are like a lot of acupuncturists, like a lot of the chi healing, chi healer, like a different. They want to find the skill, hold hope, the society, and the hope, proof, or skill. For me, my opinion, if you want to do that, just find the way where, you know, it's a Google pretty good, but sometimes you need to find on the Google, but it's, you know, just Google search. Maybe you just start to touch, then later, if you, Chinese, if you, the mind is strong, you want to go there, or you want to do something, you will got it. You know what I mean? You just like a beginning, just from what you want to learn. Then to find the teacher, or books, it's okay.
Yeah, so finding an authentic teacher is the place to start.
Kind of like that.
Okay, yeah. Rich is asking, can you speak on the relationship of the influence internal practice has on our external fate?
What's the internal ship? Can you please
say that? Yeah, maybe it's helpful to translate the.
Okay. Don't worry. So 1 minute, I'm take a little bit slowly.
This one was sent to me privately, so I'm gonna post it in the chat here.
So I want to say the respect, I want to say all the important. What's the knowledge, either the, we're the, how to say, the Chinese called the Zhou Xuan, and just say the place of some, about the importance of the, with ancestor, yeah?
Yes,
that's the next question.
Ancestor is, maybe Wu Bo, Can you help me? 就是如果我们这个祖先第一个我来讲的话，就是说，这个祖先或者一些创造者或者创造者，因为他们就是留下来的很多是一种智慧，但是也有的同时的话，他们也有留下了很多是不是智慧的东西，因为每个人在创造做一些东西的话，我们都会有真的有假的，但是作为我们的话，我们要 尊重他们所留下这种东西，我们在学习他们的同时呢，我们要学习他们哪一些更适合我们现在，就是说我们的这种应用，对我来说更如是一些，就怎么去应用。但是作为一种宗教的话，宗教的一个领袖的话，不管是一个什么样的情况下，我们必须要尊重他。就在道教中，你说道教的一些创始人呢，我们不尊重他的话，这个道教它是没办法继承的。所以呢，我们必须要去尊重他。
Just now, Shifu said, what the ancestors in the Taoism has left us could be divided into two parts. One is real wisdom that we should learn and we should inherit. But the other, they might not wisdom, but they are really created and lessons or experience from the ancestor. So our general attitude or basic attitude should to first to respect what the ancestor has given us. Otherwise, it is impossible to inherit from them. So first should be respectful, and then we should try to apply the part of wisdom into our modern life. Try to apply and to adapt them into our modern society. So this is Master Shifu's attitude.
Got it? Answer the question?
Yeah, thank you. So we'll move down to, and maybe you can translate for us the one I put because in the chat, thank you for your teaching. Can you speak on the relationship of the influence internal practice? So the neidan, taiji, changing the feng shui, you know, some of these internal practices have on our external fate and our destiny.
他就是说怎么样去练习内丹能够去影响到我们的命运。嗯，因为怎么样影响到我们这个内，我们从一个简单的一个角度来讲的话，我们从两个分两个角度来讲。第一个角度，我们在内丹，就是说，在这个道教的这个生命这个命运中呢，就是我们的生病、生老病死，包括是生病，它都是这个受这个五行的这个制约。 制药这个五行的这个制药，但是如果跟我们打通我们这个身体的时候，身体所有的经脉的时候，就是我们这个气在流动的时候，我们身体的这个病，这个生病，它也算是人命运中一阶，它都不会受这个五行的这种制药，这是一方面。嗯，先回答这么多吧。
So to answer your question, and let's look at it from a simple perspective. We people, we suffer from ill fate or we get sick because we are constrained by five elements of our life. And so if we practice alchemy, if we practice meditation, and if we practice qigong, so we will create a better circulation of qi within our body. In this way, we will remove the constraints of the constraints from the five elements, and thus we avoid getting sick, or we avoid of the ill fate. We avoid the ill fate.
那我们还有一种概念，还有一种解释。另外一种呢，我们是两个概念，还有另外一种概念是在我们这个身体里面呢，我们这个在这个 internal alchemy， 就是我们在这个练内丹的时候，它那内丹的形式是像一个搬运，通过我们的意念把你身体里面就是接的这个丹。我们刚才讲这个丹，它像是一个药一样的，一个药，是一个药，其实一个能量，我们称之为能量果。就是我们用我们的意念呢，把这个能量呢，就是说运搬运到你身体的每一个 部位，你每个部位需要这种能量的地方，所以说，那我们说是内丹，其实就是一个能量，然后用你的意念把它搬运到不同的地方，就让你身体健康起来，不会生病。
To practice internal alchemy is like first we receive energy from the outer side world, from the universe, and with a peaceful mind, and then we will carry this kind of energy to all parts of our body that is in that requires this kind of energy. We carry the energy to the weak part of the body.
嗯，对，嗯，那是，嗯，啊，yeah, it kind of like energy, yeah. Like kind of because we call the 内丹, if we say English, if we say the 内丹, actually for my opinion of my opinion of paint, it's the energy that 内丹 kind of like energy and the power, you know, it's kind of use you mind to, you know, just like a circle to the energy to different where, you know, just like a Wu Bo say, Ka Si Wu say, to the weakness or hope, the different part in the five element, five organs, or all your body. Say like, you know, if your body somewhere have problem, if you cold, you sick, we just use the energy, use your brain, use your mind, very, very strong to bring the energy, go there to healing them.
Awesome. Thank you for that explanation. The next question that I see in the chat here is from Guan Gi Kier, saying that sometimes their Tai Chi is not peaceful. And does that mean that they need to breathe more and slow down?
Okay, I can answer this question. So the Tai Chi is, you know, it's most people practice Tai Chi, I just practice Tai Chi, and no, it's not right. The first, it's like you do meditation. First, Chinese called Qiao Qi. What's Qiao Qi? Has gestate your Qi, gestate your brain, gestate your energy, adjust it first. You can be like, okay, I practice Tai Chi, I just do it. It's difficult to do peace. Like, either you ask, you are acupuncturist. If you do see a patient, you need to adjust to your mood. Just that, which, okay, I'm kind of peace, everything done, I don't leave my meditation. Then you go see the patients look at the good. You do park Tai Chi, it's the same. If you not just it, your energy, or your mind, your peace, like, you just like, okay, do it, it's no good. First, you know what you do. You know, I always, you guys, you know, we have a lot of acupuncture students always say, if you have a peace mind, peace brain, and you look at the patients more clearly, you know, the energy, what's the problem, more clearly, and you give the feeling much good, much better, then you can more have the good effect for the patients. If you like a crazy, you're crazy, you don't know what you practice, and you're an acupuncturist, you don't know what you're doing, just like crazy, the patients look at you and nervous. If you practice Tai Chi, it's the same. You know, it's the peace adjusted your energy, adjusted your mind. It's very important that you just that you cheat everything. Yeah. Make everything peace.
Awesome. So the first step is to adjust your mind even before practicing.
Yeah, and the brain is just did everything then to practice. Your way will be different. Yeah.
Awesome. The next question is from James. Very interested in you saying that Daoist magic is a form of applied psychology. In terms of the exorcism or communication with spirits, is this understood to be dealing with external entities or aspects of a person's mind, or sometimes both? That should be translated to be clear.
师父是哪一个? 我没有看见, 是哪一个?
James here is James Hunster. He asked a very interesting in your saying that that is.
Okay. 你能看得懂吗?
我有一点点，但是我可能需要你翻译。对，他说就是说在那个练法术的时候。
法术是一种那个应用的心理学，然后呢，他在驱鬼神，就是说 exorcism 和跟人交流的时候呢，是不是他是说他是，他两者都有，两者都有是吧？两者兼之有之，对，他是两者，他是两个。The master says both.
Yeah.
It's both dealing with external entities and with the person's mind.
那所以它就像我们这个治疗道教的这个治病，我们是分两种，一个是心理学，一个是药物，它是两个。那我们说是包括给人做 acupuncture 做所有的东西，它不是一个，只一个阴或只一个阳，它永远是两个兼并的，它才有更好的效果。Okay,
so just now we've given examples of Taoist and treating ill people with both with psychological measures and with you know let them drinking water with medical herb ingredients, so it's both.
Oh, everything's both. Yin yang is the best.
Cool. Awesome. Thanks for explaining. The next question here that I'm seeing is Maria, who practices Tai Chi and Qigong and would like to learn more about Daoist stillness meditation. What kind of Daoist still meditation do you recommend for beginners apart from Zhanzhuang, which she already practices?
其实我们说是站桩的话，我们还有个打坐嘛，就是打坐的话，就是它有双腿跪着坐，或者双盘坐，就是它都可以。其实说我们说这种练这种道教的一个打坐练功夫的话，它并不是一个我们常见的，它必须要打坐或者一个什么的一个形式，其实它在走路睡觉的时候，它都是可以练的。最重要是它要懂得这个调气，怎么样的一个心态 来对待这个他想练的这个东西，他这个调气是非常非常，还有调气，还有调心，它是非常重要。把这两个调好了，他在什么样的情况下都可以练。师父
said, in addition to Zhanzhuang, you can also practice meditation. There are two postures for meditation. One is to kneel down, kneel seat, right? 还有盘坐是这个 lotus seat 吗？
对对对。
The other is lotus seat. but the form is not very important. You can even practice meditation while you are walking. So the key point is that first you need to control your breath, to adjust your qi, to control your breath. And then more importantly, you need to keep your heart calm and peaceful. These are even more important than your position and posture.
包括他躺在床上也可以。
Also, you can practice while you are lying down on your bed.
All right, thank you. One more question that's popping up in the chat. And I think that this is, I'm sure that's not the only person asking this. Nicola is asking, can we learn about fortune telling for ourselves?
I want to say it's really, really difficult because you know the five elements, you have the really, really good about the five elements. Then what the fortune teller in China, we have a lot of different ways of fortune teller. One is the 四柱, just we before we talk about the 八字, and another 易经, everything. It's a little bit difficult. Maybe beginning, you can just read the book, just read like a one time, two times, three times, four times. We say maybe you can read like a thousand times, maybe you understand. If you have a teacher, maybe like a couple times, you understand. Have a teacher much easy. If you just barely read the book, you need like a thousand times, then you understand. If you just read one time, you don't understand.
Yeah, of course. Thank you for that. The last, let's see, question that's showing up here, and I have a question after that. So is Zenetica is asking, is it not good to meditate at night after one past midnight?
Where's the question?
晚上一点以后，晚上一点以后，深夜一点以后做那个调息做冥想，好不好？这个时间，他问时间。
那个我们说的是这个, I think it's the most people know the most the Daoism, or you know the Christians and the same one practice, and it's all practiced all the skills and understand. 那我们这样来讲吧，那个子时我们这样就分为子时、子时和午时。总的来讲，其实我们分四个子午卯酉，就是四正方子午卯酉。我不能这么说呢。我们这个时间都会去打坐，但是这个子时这时候是子时说作为一个道人，他是一个专业练习的一个人，他来讲究这个时间，他会控制这个时间。所以一般的一个人来练习这种气功啊，或大部分这种气功打坐的话，我们没有必要非常在乎这个时间，因为我们要的目的不一样。因为古代作为专业的话，他们是为了达到另外一个境界，就是说真正的或者成仙得道啊，就是包括这个饮食、啊、所有东西都特别特别讲究，这是专业的。
So for professional Taoist, it's important to practice meditation or to practice at a specific time because they have different purposes in practicing rather than common people, like they want to have achieve some Taoist achievements or to become immortal. They have totally different pursuits. But for common people, any time is okay.
嗯，yeah，it's the time. You know, if you're, I think we have like a Neidan class before and the same, and I will hear probably a lot of students, you know, follow me practice Neidan. We talk about the time. It's, you know, if you are want to be a professional practitioner, like a professional who really want to practice the, like the economy, want to really like change the time, then yes, internal alchemy, you need the time. The bit, you know, it's the specific of the time, specific. Yeah.
Totally. Yeah, that's something that students can learn more about in the next Neidan course that comes up. That's a practice we got into is times of day of meditation. One question that I wanted to ask, since you know, I was around a lot more living on that side of the country during earlier phases. Last year was the ox year. I haven't asked Shifu, what should we be thinking about in terms of divination, in terms of the seasonal qi in this year? And the rest of this year, if you have any recommendations for people, what to expect, what to be careful of, these sort of things.
Wow, this is in colonial, the fortune teller the part. the familiar point of view, I say we'll be okay. It's a much better than the past few years. Everything getting be better. For the life, the destiny of the life of humans, you know, the destiny of human, all the human, like the different country, it's still a little bit difficult, but it's getting the better, you know. Because Chinese call 物极必反, how to say, 武博? 物极必反, 物极必反.
If you go to extreme, and then you will go to the opposite.
So we are talking about, you know, actually here we're not really talking a lot of politics because, you know, I love talking, I don't like politics, but I like to talk about politics, you know, either country is country, everything. You know, we always talk about a lot of people talking about Russia, this thing. I say, you know, everything have just like yesterday, the Mingdao, he's very, very good. The bad is good. You know, I really love his topic. And it's the good, the bad stuff, a lot of people die. We don't like it. You know, everybody don't like it, but it's the happened because of the country, each country, the situation different, the environment different, the influence different. You know, it's the everything. Just like economy go up, they have to go down. You know, go down a little bit, they have to go up. It's all the peace, everything is the same. Either the Russia, because of the environment, it's not about Putin, because all Russia, the political environment like that. You know, it's America environment, the political environment is different. So in the Russia, they did the bad stuff, the, you know, they clear the war, they clear the war, but also good for another country. You know, it's the world everywhere getting separate. If this one no solute, for future have bigger problem. No, it's all the country very, very tight. No, you know, all Europe, United States, all tight. The people figure out what's good, what's bad. You know, it's like before people, they don't know what is good, what's bad, what is the real need. You know, not the war is bad for Ukraine, but good for the world. People, everybody think about it. In the United States, they're not solid, no spirit too much, you know. Like everything's getting tight, you know. Everything, oh, okay, we have to fight in that. You know, everything's good as bad. I want to say, no, it's supposed to start to better, you know.
All right, thank you for that insight. That looks like it concludes our questions, and it's perfect timing. So we definitely want to say thank you, Master Zhou, for speaking. Thank you, Wubo, for translating. And thank you for everyone that helps make this event possible. We're going to be back in the afternoon at 2 p.m. Eastern time. That's 11 if you're on my time in the West Coast. And we have people from all over the world. So I'm sure you figured it out if you were here yesterday. And look forward to seeing you all there. Lindsay Wei will be presenting on Zhenwu, which we already introed at the beginning of this talk a little bit. So talking
okay, Wudang, Mark words. Awesome. I'll see you afternoon.
Bye.
See everyone soon. Thank you.